Well, Merry Christmas. Great to see you here and celebrating the first Sunday after Christmas. I was going to leave it to Father Christian to preach on that John's Gospel on Christmas Day, and I'm going to avoid that this morning. But I wanted us to think together this morning. Here we are on New Year's Eve. And tomorrow, January 1st, most of Western world will be observing New Year's Day. Of course, here in America, we'll be observing Football Day. But the church has provided a different observance for January 1st, and it's the day when liturgical Christians consider an event in Jesus' life which places him in compliance with ancient Jewish law by undergoing the ancient rite of circumcision, by which he became officially a child of the covenant and received a name. Luke tells us in the second chapter, when the day came and the child was to be circumcised, they gave him the name Jesus, the name the angel had given him before he was conceived. And the way Luke wrote that implies that it's the name that's important. They gave him the name Jesus. So I want us to think this morning about names and about January 1st being Jesus' naming day. Shakespeare asked, "What's in a name? A rose by any other name would smell as sweet." But I would suggest to you that names are important. Jesus' name and your name. I want to ask you this morning to consider the meaning of your name and the significance of name giving. Names today, I think, are often chosen by fads. You know, you can Google and say, what are the 10 most popular boy names or girl names, and get a list of names to give your child, or you can even do it for your dog if you want to do that. But I haven't done that. But they're often chosen by fads or perhaps to honor someone in the family. And way back long ago, people just had one name, very often derived by their occupation or maybe what they looked like or where they lived. My last name, Scheel in German, means squint-eyed. I must have had an ancestor who was nearsighted or cross-eyed or something. And my first name, William, comes from the German and Wilhelm, and means strong protector. I like that. In the thought of the ancient world, a name, though, does not merely designate or distinguish one person from other persons, but the name is closely related to the nature of the bearer, to the nature of the being that carries that name. And the name of a deity in particular is regarded as part of the being, the essence of the being so named. It is part of that God's, small g, small God's character and powers. So the name, therefore, was thought of as having a higher degree of importance, of reality, of substantiality than just identification. It's not just something you call someone. And the Hebrews shared in that way of thinking. In the Old Testament, the name is a kind of a double for the deity. In the book Numbers, the sixth chapter, there is a priestly blessing, and you've heard it. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord uncover his face to you and bring you peace. And that's not only a petition to God on the behalf of Israel, but it's a means of conveying a power to the people or an influence on them. For we are told, for when priests say my blessing, they put my name on the children of Israel. They put my name, God's name, on the children of Israel. Well, when I read that prayer, I read a modern, not so modern, translation. May the Lord bless you and keep you. And there, the Lord is a substitution for God's name. For God's name. And what is God's name that is makes it too holy to say, too sacred to speak out loud? It's the name he told Moses on Sinai. And in Hebrew, which you may know, has no vowels. It's four consonants. YHVH. We think that's pronounced Yahweh. Yahweh. And over the years, it became so sacred that nobody said it out loud, so we've lost the accurate pronunciation. But the meaning of the word is he who is. It's often translated, as you know, translated in the King James Version as I am who I am, or I am what I am. But what it really means more is, I am he who is present. One scholar I've read and I really like says that it means, I will be with you. I love that. Consider that the God who created the whole universe promises his people that his name is, I will be with you. And remember that the name signifies something of the character and the power of the bearer. So we come to the name of God's Son. It's Christmas. We're celebrating the birth of God's Son, born to a human mother and carrying God's nature, God's character, God's being, his essence, his powers. And that name, we say Jesus from the Latin. It's Yeshua in Aramaic, the language Jesus spoke, and in late Hebrew. It's Joshua in Hebrew, and as I say, Jesus derived in Greek and Latin. And the meaning of that word is Yahweh saves. Yahweh saves. And Matthew tells us that he got that name because he shall save his people from their sins. Remember, in the Old Testament, it's Joshua who succeeds Moses and leads the people of Israel through the Jordan River into the Promised Land. And it is Jesus, Yeshua, Joshua, who leads his people through the water of baptism into the Promised Land, a new life, a new relationship with God. And so his name, Jesus' name, is both a sign of the mission he is to fulfill, and it's a summons, a call to fulfill it. And his mission was to be Messiah. And in Greek, that's Christ. You know, the it means the anointed one. Priests and kings in the Old Testament were anointed with oil for their job, their specially chosen function. And God has specially chosen Jesus for the function of restoration, restoring his relationship with his people. And by the way, in case you didn't catch it, Jesus is not his first name and Christ his last name. His first name, his only name, is Jesus. Christ is his mission, his job. And that's why when I'm reading the liturgy, I pause just a little bit in between Jesus and Christ. And of course, over the years, we have given him other names: Wonderful Counselor, Almighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, Lord, Savior. And as Paul tells us, God has given him a name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. And as Jesus' name is a programmatic definition of the whole purpose of Christmas, the incarnation, it's what it's all about. Similarly, our baptismal names are programmatic for us. He received his name in accordance with Hebrew law on the eighth day after birth at his circumcision. We get our names at baptism. There's a point in the old baptism service where we used to say, the priest used to say to the family, name this child. Now we don't have that request, but it still says in the fine print in the prayer book, the sponsors or parents shall name the child. And so the name is given to us. It gives us meaning and identity and purpose in life on behalf of God and not on our own. Our baptismal name is given to us, put on us, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit is laid over our name. His name is linked with ours. And his name and what he has done for us makes it possible for us to realize the program that's denoted by our name. We can fulfill the meaning of our names only by developing a Christ-like character. Now, each one of us makes our own name and its meaning. You remember being told growing up, go out and make a name for yourself. And each one of us is somewhere in the process of doing that. And at this time of the year, as we wind up 2023, it might be well for each of us to look at our own name and see how we're doing with it. You know, what kind of a name are you making or have you made so far for yourself? What do other people think of you when they hear the mention of your name? What does God, who sees things as they really are, think? What have you added to your name and his in the past year? Do you plan any changes for the coming year? I don't know about you, but have you noticed about people that it's inconceivable that they should bear any other name than the one they have, whether for good or for ill? And that's because they have shaped and molded their name by the way they have lived, by the kind of people they are. Would you pray with me, please? Eternal Father, you gave to your incarnate Son the holy name of Jesus to be the sign of our salvation. Plant in every heart, we pray, the love of him who is the Savior of the world, and grant that through your help, all of us who bear his name with our own may in our lives reflect only honor and glory on the name of our Lord Jesus the Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, in glory everlasting.